Paris, my son came in May 1936.
Now, tell the court what happened on the 27th of October 1938.
27. October 1938.
27. October 1938 haben wir gewusst. War in meinem Donnerstagabend, 8 Uhr, kam rein ein Polizist. Sie werden kommen auf dem 11. Revier mit den Pässe. Sie kommen gleich zurück. Sie brauchen gar nicht mitzunehmen.
On the 27th of October 1938, it was Thursday night at 8 o'clock, a policeman came and told us to come to Region 11. He said, you're going to come back immediately, you shouldn't take anything with you. Take with you your passports.
The court, if you are tired, you may sit down.
Your Honours, I can stand. Thank you.
Whom did he ask to come to the police? Whom of your family, of the members of your family?
Wemen von einem Spruch hat mir gesucht, er darf kommen ins Revier.
In mir allein.
Rakuti.
Mit meiner Familie.
In Mishpachti.
Just myself. I was asked to go along with my family.
In jene, in der Tochter, in meine Frau und ich.
Kol Mishpachti.
All my family, my son who is sitting upstairs, my daughter, my wife and myself.
And then what happened?
Die Leute haben mich reingeführt in den Revier. Ich kam rein in den Revier, sehe ich, das sind schon hunderte Menschen. Einer reißt vom Kopf, einer schlagt sich, einer weint, eine kleine Kinder, alte Leute, spalisieren, unterschreiben, dem Ausweis. Sie werden ausgewiesen.
When I reached the region, I saw a large number of people. Some people were sitting, some standing, people were crying, they were shouting, sign.
The court, not everybody was shouting. Who instructed him to sign on the deportation order of the vacation?
Polizei inspector.
The police inspector.
What did you do?
Ich müsste unterschreiben, es geht wie alle unterschreiben. Einer hat mich unterschrieben, gewisser Gerschen Silber. Ich sage, ich stand im Winkel 24 Stunden zu strukturieren für den Platz. Er hat mir etwas erregt, der gleiche Krieg über den Kopf. Schlagen hat Befehle auf die Stelle. Dann hat man uns genommen, hat uns abgeführt im Konzerthaus, haben Ufer an der Leine. Damit sind wir da zusammen von allen Revieren, waren wir da. Beinahe bis 600 Mann.
Einen Moment.
Okay, egal.
I had to sign, like as all of them did. One of us did not, and his name was, I believe, was Gershon Zilber, and he had to stand in the corner about 24 hours. They took us to the concert hall on the banks of the Leine, and there were people from all the areas, about 600 people.
How long did you stay there?
Bis Freitag auf der Nacht, 24 Stunden war es. Bis Freitag auf der Nacht, bis Freitag.
There we stayed till Friday night, about 24 hours, yes, till Friday night.
And then?
Dann haben sie uns genommen, aufgepackt auf den Green August, das heißt die Polizeiwagen. Zu 20 Mann auf einem Wagen und abgeführt zum Bahnhof. Die Straßen waren schwarz, raus mit den Juden nach Palästina.
Then they took us in police trucks, in prisoners' lorries, about 20 men in each truck, and they took us to the railway station. The streets were full of people shouting, "The Jews out to Palestine."
The prosecution correct. The streets were black with people.
Then we came on the Bahn, hat uns abgeführt und wir kommen nach Neubenchen.
When we got to the train, they took us by train to Neubenchen on the German Polish border. It was Shabbat morning, Saturday morning.
The prosecution, you were on the in the train. Who was with you?
Together with them all, about 600 people altogether.
Prosecution, the police was there?
My wife and children.
With the family? How were you taken care of in the train?
Berlin, Hamburg, Köln, Düsseldorf, und so weiter. Bielefeld, Essen, Bremen, angekommen Ziege, waren mit 12.000 Mann.
When we reached Neubenchen at 6 a.m., there came trains from all sorts of places, Leipzig, Köln, Düsseldorf, Essen, Bielefeld. From Bremen, together we were about 12,000 people.
When you came there, what was the day of the week?
It was the Sabbath day, the 29th of October.
Mr. Grinspan, did you inform anybody about this evacuation?
When we reached the border, we were searched to see if anybody had any money, anybody who had more than 10 mark, the consecutive interpreter correct. 10 mark. The balance was taken from him. This was the German law. No more than 10 mark could be taken out of Germany. The German says you didn't bring any more into Germany, you can't take any more out.
And then when you came to the front, did you inform anyone of your arrival?
With whom could we have any contact? The SS were giving us, as it were, protective custody, and we walked 2 kilometers on foot to the Russian border.
Wir kamen 2 Kilometer weiter, hat angefangen die SS von unten mit den Peitschen über die Köpfe. Schlagen, die wir kannten nicht gehen, hatten sie gezogen an Quisch. Das Blut hatte gegossen an allen Seiten. Man hat rausgerissen, die Pakete, welche man gehabt in die Hände, geschmissen in die Seite. Sehr barbarisch haben sie damals bewiesen. Das erste Mal habe ich gesehen damals die Hauptbarbarigkeit von dem deutschen Volk.
To whom could we write? We were on our way to the Polish border. They told us to go. The SS men were hitting us with whips. Those who were tarrying, they hit, and blood was flowing on the road. They tore away their little baggages from them. They treated us in a most barbaric fashion. This is the first time that I'd ever seen the wild barbarism.
dann kann wir unter getrimmt laufen, aber schnell laufen. Ich habe selbst gekriegt einen Stoß von hinten, ich bin reingefangen in einem Graben, bin ich reingefangen. Der Sohn hat mich gehabt an der Hand. Der Papa kommt, sonst wäre es der Tod.
Hey, Itzubano, la rutz nim hirut, la rutz.
He shouted at us, run, run. I myself received a blow and I fell in a ditch. My boy helped me and he said, run, run, Dad, otherwise you'll die.
Dann kamen wir auf die Grenze, die polnische Grenze, hatten uns hereingelassen in Polen. Auf der freien Grenze waren wir erst. Auf der Grenze, heißt Grüne Grenze, auf Deutsch. Waren wir erst und dann, die Frauen waren schon durch, weil auf der Frauen haben sie angefangen zu schießen. Die Polen wussten nicht, so viele Menschen. Mit einmal, wer sind sie? Es kamen ein General und zwei Offizier und haben kontrolliert, die Passagen gesehen, sind polnische Bürger. Auslandspässe. Er hat gesagt, wir müssen reinlassen. Haben wir uns reingelassen, kamen wir rein in eine Stadt von 6.000 Einwohnern, wir waren 12, die hatten einen Kuh hinzufahren. Der Regen hat geschlagen, Menschen sind gefangen. Nummer, einige sind gefangen für Herzschlag. Es sind gelegen ausgezogen, Menschen, man hat sie geschleppt von allen Seiten. Wir mussten alles erkennen. Alte Frauen, alte Männer, Kinderkleine, es war der Jammer war sehr groß. Wir hatten kein Essen, wir wollten nicht essen seit Donnerstag an, wollten mehr kein deutsches Brot essen. Und wir haben nicht in Bonschine gehabt, nichts zu kaufen und gar nichts zu bekommen.
When we got to the open border, we reached the what was called the green border, the Polish border. First of all, the women went in. The Poles didn't know.
The court asks the interpreter to go slowly.
And then a Polish general and some officers arrived, and they examined the papers, and they saw that we were Polish subjects, that we had special passports. It was decided to let us enter Poland. They took us into a village which had about 6,000 people, and we were 12,000. The rain was driving hard. People were falling and fainting. Some suffered heart attacks. On all sides, one saw old men and women, and our suffering was great. There was no food. We did not want already from Thursday to eat any German bread.
Prosecution, when did you come
to the camp?
The same day we reached the camp, since there wasn't any room, they put us into a military camp, and I say specifically, and they put us into the stables in that camp, because there was no other place.
Prosecution, when you arrived to that camp, did you write? The court calls attention that the Hebrew interpretation was not full.
Yes, there was horse dung in those stables in which we were placed.
We were all hungry. We had 2 days not gegessen, 2 or 3 days. Erst Sonntag. Montag morgens ist sie angekommen, nein, Sonntag morgens ist angekommen, für Pausen, eine Maschine mit Brot.
I think it was the second day. On the first day, a lorry with bread came from Poznan.
And after... You received bread, you did receive bread on Sunday?
Selbstverständlich sind alle befallen, die Maschine kennt sich keinen Rat geben, haben geschmissen das Brot über die Köpfe. Wer hat gehabt? Wer hat gefangen? Der hat gehabt. Nachher ist angekommen, noch ein bisschen. Also sie haben so viele Maschinen gekommen, bis der Oilem ist satt geworden.
At first there was a great crush. The lorry, from the lorry they couldn't divide out the bread in any other way. Whoever got the bread was lucky, the one who didn't. And then came other trucks until everybody had some bread.
And then?
Nach diesen habe ich geschrieben einen Brief nach Deutschland, nach Frankreich zum Benzin. Schreib nicht mehr nach Deutschland. Wir befinden sich jetzt in Bonn.
Then I wrote a letter to Germany, no, to France, to my son. Don't write any more letters to Germany. We are now in Zbonjin in Poland.
And this son was Herschel Grinspan.
Die Deutschen und herausgenommen die jüdischen Männer für den Stieb, nicht ausgewählt für das Pfarrerjahrgang, von 14 Uhr.
The Germans went from one house to another and took the men without any consideration for age, my father amongst them.
In Marek, in Wielicki. Man hat sie geheißen, halten die Hände verlegt auf dem Hals.
They were all put up in the marketplace in Wielicka and ordered to hold their hands on the back of their neck.
Es ist auch gewesen, nach dem Lastauto, ein Taxi, mit zwei Offizieren.
Behind the truck, there was a taxi with two officers, 32 Jewish men were taken that day.
In Polish men are also?
Polish men as well.
In später Weg um sie gehabt.
Later.
Intellektualist, das heißt der Professor von Gymnasium, Agalev.
Later, they also caught intellectuals, a professor at a high school, a priest, four people.
Will you please answer my questions and it will be easier?
Mir hat die Männer auf dem Lastwagen weggenommen.
Man konnte mit mir abgeschrieben die Namen und gemacht Bilder, diese alle.
Question. Did they take the males on a truck?
They were first photographed and their names were recorded.
Und dann hat man sie mit Schlucken, und dann haben sie noch marschiert über Marek mit der verleichten Hand und geschrieben in Semme verrechtet von dem Volk. Zum Bedürfnis, gemisst schreien, wir sind die Verräter von dem Volk.
And then they were marched in the marketplace and were forced to cry out, we are traitors of the people, while their hands are still at the...
In what language?
In the German language.
Presiding Judge, you can sit down, madam, if you wish. You can stand? All right.
Your ear hot...
Did you see this with your own eyes?
Yes.
And what happened to these males?
Then they were put onto those trucks and taken away.
What did you do?
I went with the young lady who was supposed to be my sister-in-law. We ran after the truck. Four men were removed from her house. A father, two brothers, and a brother-in-law.
Bis im Wald.
Bis a kleine Verdo, a ring Verdo.
We ran after them until a small forest known as Tashitz.
What did you see there in Tashitz?
They were, all the Jews taken were already dead on the ground. My father as well, shot in many places, many parts of his body. They were all, they were all killed by shooting. They were all stretched out on the ground according to a pattern. Groups, in groups of five men, Jews alone and Poles alone. The four Poles I mentioned, they were lying separately.
Question from the court. Were these Poles the same four males whom you mentioned before?
Yes.
What did you do?
I ran back to town. First, I kissed my father. He was cold as ice because he bleeded profusely, although it was only 1 hour after they were taken. When I arrived in town, I went to the council of the community and begged for help to bury our dead.
Did you bury your father?
Yes, on the same day. On the following day, in the morning.
Later they take you to work in Velichka.
Yes.
What work was it?
We had to clean the streets in Velichka.
How did you do this?
We were taken out of our homes, we were given brooms, pails, we had to collect the garbage with our hands.
You escaped to Krakow?
Yes.
When was this?
A few weeks
after
the killing of my father.
Can you remember what happened to the Jews in Krakow in November 1939?
On one day in the morning, the Jewish quarter was sealed off. There was a quarter wherein the Jews were kind of centralized.
In deutsche Sennes-Offizieren sind wild herein in jeden Stieb. קודם haben sie geschrien schon heraus finde ich die heraus geworfen finde schön Karls geschlagen genichtet
soldiers and officers Germans burst into the homes, shouted that all men were to come out, took out everything from the cupboards and cabinets, destroyed and beat us up.
Did
they shoot?
They was gewesen ungetein in chassidischem Albischem, haben sie ihm geheißen tanzen und singen jüdische Davenslieder, also wenn wir Daven, und sie haben gemacht Bilder, nachher hat er Deutsch genommen, als Ende, er hat gesagt zu mir, er soll machen eine Pose, wie der Jid steckt im Deutsch.
We had a neighbor, an old orthodox man, they put they put a hen into his hand and ordered him to dance and sing prayers. He was dressed in Hasidic garb. And then he was told to pretend that he was choking a German, and this was photographed.
Das hat man fotografiert.
Als hat man fotografiert.
Ja, was hat man dann gemacht? Sehr zu lang, erkennt man sehr zu lang.
Ein Mensch hat mit Demos geschossen.
Asia Rube, Anashim Rabim.
Many were shot, many were killed.
Wer hat das alles gemacht?
Who did this?
German soldiers in uniform, in German uniform.
Did you have to wear any badge?
Yes.
We had to wear white striped, white armbands with a blue Magen David.
Do you know anything about a Jewish council?
Everywhere they had councils, Jewish councils.
Später sind ihr übersiedelt in Mielitz.
Later,
after that you moved over to Mielitz.
Winterzeit.
This was in the winter.
What did you do there?
Dort bin ich gegangen auf Zwangarbeit, hab gearbeitet bei Melioratie und bei Modgebäut Weg zum Bahn.
I had to do compulsory work for the amelioration of soil and for the making a road for the railway.
Can you remember what happened there in the synagogue?
The Jews were gathered,
especially
older men.
They
were all gathered into a large synagogue in Mielitz.
Geschochten und geschossen, in welche sind in ein Haus gesprungen vom Fenster, hat man sie Badewand geschossen.
And there they were slaughtered and killed by shooting. Those who tried to escape from the windows were shot on the spot outside.
What happened to Jews who had beards?
Very often, a motorcycle,
Sirak,
where the sidecar would come along, and they would catch those bearded Jews.
Mit Stücklech Fleisch.
Leitim nasa ofnoa im sira, vehem chatfu yehudim barchov.
They would catch Jews off the streets or from the houses, bearded, bring them, shave them, the whole beard or half of the beard, together with pieces of flesh.
Im Jahr 41 hat man gerät über machen mehr als Judenrein.
In 1941 they spoke about making, about cleansing Vielitz of Jews.
Was haben die Juden gemacht, um die Gzere überführen?
What did the Jews do in order to stop this, avert this evil decree?
Gesucht das modgelegte Kontribution auf die Juden, wird man können bleiben in der Stiegen.
The Jews said that a compulsory fine was put upon the Jews, and if they paid, they'd be able to stay in their homes.
No.
Did they leave you in Vielitz?
No.
What did they do to you?
First, we handed over all we had. Jewels, coffee, furs, and we were promised that we would be allowed to stay.
And
on the following morning, we were surrounded by units, clad in black and green uniforms, drove us out of our homes onto the marketplace. The sick and the weak who could not run immediately were shot on the place or in bed.
And then had been ausgestellt, blieben auf dem Markt.
And those who remained were put up in the marketplace. Then the young men were selected.
Und in sie gewähnen alle Jiden in der Mitte.
The young were put to one side, the women, children and the old were roped off, and in the center, we were in the center. Between two rows of black and green uniformed soldiers roped us off.
Thus,
we were made to run, and he who fell was shot on the place with whips and sticks and shootings. We walked this way from Mielitz. There was a factory for Polish airplanes, Bergehof.
Dort sind wir schon gekommen, es gewesen, vorher Nacht, es ist gewesen, kalt, Schnee, heuer mit den Zahlen reingepackt in die Hangaren.
We arrived in the evening, it was cold and the snow was high, we were all put into the hangars.
Gilos Taroiskain, Cesaros gegangen, erledigten physiologische Bedarfnis. hat man ihm geschossen.
Were not permitted to leave the hangars, and he who went out for physical reasons was shot.
The judge, you were then quite a young girl.
I was over 20, married.
Dort mit in der Hangar zu Harim gedreht Militärleit und so geschlagen.
In the hangars, soldiers went round and kept on beating us.
Which army people were there?
There were yellow uniforms, green uniforms, and black uniforms.
Which units were there, do you know?
I did not know the units at the time, but later I knew they were SS men, SD men and SA men.
They kept on beating,
and many of us. Many kept up the beatings, and many went out of their minds.
As we should scan for a child, to listen, so sein und zu trinken, a weinende Kind, hat man gezahlt mit Ringler und mit Bijouterie.
If one tried to melt a piece of snow to give to a thirsty child, one had to pay with rings and jewels.
When we were going to get rid of them, we were going to get rid of them.
And if one left the hangar by permission, he was shot after a few steps.
Later you were in a village called Dubinka.
Yes. The Jews were evacuated and we were kept on the run. Then we went to another camp on our way.
I know about the previous place. I'm asking you now about Dubinka. Do you remember what happened on Jewish festivals in Dubinka?
Mit den Köpfen der jungen Menschen und später hat man sie alle daher
gegeben.
This was near to Shavuot, the Feast of the Pentecost. They took the young men, the ages 18 to 22, up to 25 years of age. They were taken to the forest and put on a fictitious fight because the partisans were active at that time, and they put up a fight as though the Jews the Jews took the part of the partisans, and this was photographed. They had the heads and arms of the Jews broken, and all of them were killed later. I was present when they were buried and saw the mutilated bodies.
Do you remember what happened there to Orthodox Jews.
Es gewesen ein Bergl, auf dem Bergl haben sie zusammengejuckt, ein bisschen von jedem Berg, 20 Mann, ungetinnende Kleider, Becken, Leißen, mit Zides in der Hand.
I lived in a house, and from my window I could see a hill, where they gathered some 20 Orthodox men, taken out of their homes, dressed in Hasidic robes, prayer shawls, and prayer books in their hands. They were ordered to chant religious hymns, to pray, to raise their hands in supplication to God. And then the officers went up to them and poured kerosene and petrol under those Jews and set fire to all the Jews. While they were in their prayer shawls, holding their prayer books in supplication to God.
I saw it yourself?
With my own eyes. It all happened before my window. We were not permitted to leave the houses. We sat back home and watched the goings on from the window.
Can you remember an elderly Jew who was walking along with his paralyzed grandchild? Tell us what happened with him. What happened to him?
In Dobienke, my parents-in-law lived with a family. Yes, there was an Orthodox Jew with a skull cap. Little black caps. He had a grandchild in his home. Who was in plaster. And when the Jews were chased out of Dobienke, we were being chased to a camp in Hub Yeshuv.
On the
way, the grandfather was stopped, holding the child in his arms because the child could not walk. They shot the grandfather first, although the child kept on shouting, "Shoot me first," and then they shot the child.
Mr. Hasner, can we complete this evidence today? I would like you to complete this evidence, if possible, this morning. What did they do there with children who cried?
They were shot.
What did the parents do to prevent the children from crying?
They gagged the children. The parents gagged their children's mouths if they cried.
Your Honor, with regard to the chapter which we now wish to unfold to the court. This is as much as we need to say, but the witness can tell us things which no other people can tell us about the camp in Sobibor. I therefore request permission to call this witness again when we come to this chapter.
We were all facing
Judge Landau, please sit down, Dr. Bejsky. I ask you please to sit down.
We were all gathered there, and two were taken to the gallows, a boy of 15, Halbenstock, and the engineer, Grautwirth.
Mr. Hausner, why?
Ordered
why?
To be
what
hanged.
Was their offense?
As was told, the rumors in the camp that the boy, he sang a song to a Russian tune, and Kaltwirth, I do not know what he was
charged with. Please go on with your description.
The boy, Halbenstock, was hanged, and something happened, the rope snatched. The boy was put up again on a high chair under the rope and started begging for his life. He was ordered to be hanged again, and he did go up to the gallows once again and hanged, and then he was shot at. The engineer was on the second chair, and here the perfidy reached even further. The SS men came with their machine guns and ordered the men to gaze and look as the hanging was being carried out. And the engineer Krautwirth cut his veins with a razor, and thus he was hanged,
bleeding.
And this is how he was hanged. It is difficult, if it is necessary, to describe again when people stand around, not tens, but hundreds of SS men with machine guns and bayonets, and if one has to stand and gaze at the hanging.
Mr. Hausner, Dr. Bejsky, 15,000 people were standing there and hundreds of guards were facing you. Why didn't you revolt? Why didn't you charge and attack these guards?
I believe that this is difficult to describe or to answer. There is not a single answer. I can describe the general situation, and maybe this will explain. It is difficult to understand, especially by those who were not there. This was the middle of 43, the third year of war, and this was not the beginning. It started with something else. People, Jews, were desperate by all that already happened during the 3 years. That is one thing. And secondly, there was still hope. People are working, compulsory work. Maybe, perhaps, it was clear that at that moment, if anyone made a move, the slightest, there would have been no difficulty when the guardsman, may I sit down now, please? And the witness sits down by permission of the court.
Judge Landau, you may take a rest if you wish.
First, today, I too, after 18 years, cannot describe the feeling of fear. The fear today when I stand before your honors does not exist any longer. And I believe that one cannot describe it. This was a terror. The gazing itself on the hanging of a boy, he's asking for. There is no possibility of reacting. And the belief that the war will end one day and to endanger 15,000 men. And even then, if we would make an attempt, where to? Near us, there were Poles, 1,000 Poles, they were also shot and killed, and 100 meters away from the camp, they had their homes, where to run? But where could a Jew run to? We were in clothes. At that time, they were not concentration camp clothes, but they were all dyed yellow, stripes. The head was not a usual haircut, but there was a kind of shaving in the center of 4 centimeters wide. And even if we for a moment say that 15,000 men succeed to leave the camp, where to? What could we do? Inside the camp, it seemed, and don't forget, please, that in 1943, we did not know yet what happened to our families and all those who were sent off by all the deportations. We learned about this only later. We thought that by going on working, and these are not the only reasons. He who tries to find the reasons today, I doubt it if he will succeed because of the very simple reason. One cannot describe the conditions which existed at the time to the court. And I am not afraid that someone will not be able to understand what happened. But I know it from my flesh and blood. The question, dialectically, may be asked, but the condition to describe what was going on, the conditions are not there. The situation was entirely different. I will bring only one example, a very classical example. There was a martyrologue in the camp. We were all in the same boat, but if we take Grimberg, an engineer beloved by everybody in the camp and appointed to plan the putting up of those huts, the building of the camp, I cannot remember the man without scars and wounds. The man daily, either dogs or beatings, 100 whips or fists, because the work on one of the huts was not speedy enough. He who prayed and asked, shoot me, but he never committed suicide. This is even more surprising and amazing. There was a man with his daughter in the camp. His daughter and wife were from time to time taken to prison to frighten him and scare him, to make him commit something. This man, in addition to all what the inmates suffered, if there are 100 stages in hell, he went through all of them. He was killed finally, but the fact is, this was the situation. Try to explain it today. You and the explanation conditions were different. The Polish jewelry already passed through hell until they came to Plaszów.
I'm prepared to explain this.
No, yes, please answer yes or no. Who was Anton Schmidt?
Anton Schmidt, he was a Feldwebel, a junior officer.
He was killed finally, but the fact is, this was the situation. Try to explain it today. You cannot find the explanation. Conditions were different. The Polish jury already passed through hell until they came to Plaszów.
I'm prepared to explain this.
No, yes, please answer yes or no. Who was Anton Schmidt?
Anton Schmidt, he was a Feldwebel, a junior officer in the Wehrmacht of Austrian origin. He was the commander of a unit whose task was to gather stray soldiers who had been cut off from their units. The story of Anton Schmidt is one of the rare and amazing stories of those days.
Will you please be short? You contacted Anton Schmidt.
We did.
The first,
and Mordechai Tenenbaum-Tamarov, made his acquaintance.
And since October 41, the underground had contact with Schmidt, and he endangered his life to help you.
That is true.
And he did it not for money.
Correct.
He supplied your men with certificates, gave you military trucks.
That is also true.
And this is what was called the Bialystok operation.
Yes, that's what we called it, Operation Bialystok.
Do you remember that one evening you met Anton Schmidt secretly in January 42?
I do remember.
You were awaiting one of your envoys.
That is true.
Schmidt was nervous.
He was.
You had a few drinks.
Mm-hmm.
And you asked for details about Gestapo men.
Yes.
What did Anton Schmidt say to you?
When I asked him and asked him to explain who they were and what it depended upon, because I was among those who had reservations about smuggling people to Bialystok, not because of the risks, and there was a considerable risk, but we took a lot of people. It was a great distance from Vilna to Bialystok in military trucks, but I was bothered by one thought. If we had one fate, if this was total annihilation, what's the use of running away from one place to another? I wanted to know who this depended on. Some people thought this depended on one commander, the other local commander, this Gestapo man or the other Gestapo commander. I asked them about Schwanenberg, about Hinks, about Miller, about Weiss, about Lozer, about all these local commanders. At a certain moment, I remembered when he told me that those have no say. There is one man, I remember this with great precision, there is one dog called Eichmann, and he is organizing all of this. That's when I first heard that name. I did not know who he was, what he was. I wanted more details. At that moment, he sobered up and he said, "Man, I never told you anything. I won't say anything anymore."
Do you remember his words in German?
Yes, I think I do.
What did he say in German?
"Diese haben nichts zu sagen." He said, "They have nothing to say. There is a dog named Eichmann, and he arranges everything."
Które było okryte z dzieckiem niemowlęciem, które miało około półtora roczku.
This Kardash caught a woman with a baby in her arms of about 18 months.
Trzymała ona to dziecko na ręku i on złapał ją. I ona zaczęła go prosić, żeby ją zastrzelił, a dziecko, żeby darował życie.
Herzika ba jelet.
She held the baby in her arms and began asking for mercy, that she be shot first and leave the baby alive.
którzy wyciągali ręce, chcieli to dziecko wziąć.
From behind the fence there were Poles who raised their hands ready to catch the baby. She was about to hand the baby over to the Poles.
Ona się wywróciła, on sobie stanął jedną nogą na nogę dziecka i drugą rozdarł to dziecko, tak jak się drze szmaty. To widziałam.
He took the baby from her arms, shot her twice, and then took the baby in his hands and tore him as one would tear a rag.
On rzucił to dziecko, zaczął się śmiać. Ona się doczulgała do tego dziecka, skrwawiona, to dziecko się rzucało, ona złapała to dziecko i razem tak z tym dzieckiem skonała.
Hayelet Hillel wept and cried.
Hayelet,
he threw the baby. The mother crawled bleeding up to her baby, and thus together they died.
Zobaczył, że tam bieg jakiś pies. Bezpański.
He laughed and saw that a stray dog was crossing the street.
I wyciągnął z kieszeni, czy to cukier, czy kawałek wędliny, dał temu psu zjeść i odeszedł z tym psem, głaskając go.
Started petting the dog, took out something of his pocket, a lump of sugar, and gave the dog, took the dog with him.